Hello, welcome to this episode of Auto Tutorials by Levonotion Studios. Hi, I'm Lydia, and in this episode, I'm going to show you how to use UDIM for DAZ materials in Blender. Let's get started. So, in DAZ, I have this default Genesis 8 character, and she has this simple outfit on. So, I'm going to export her to Blender. So I'm going to use the FBX, Autodesk FBX format. So I'm going to replace this, yes. So now the only thing I changed here is instead of the embed, I uncheck embed textures and clicked on collect textures. And the reason why I did this is because I don't want the textures to be embedded in the files, because if they're embedded, I still have to unzip them, rename them, and then use. So instead of going through those stress, I just collect them in a folder. So this is where I have the file. So I'm just going to click on accept. It's going to convert the task character to FBX. So it's done converting. So now you see this folder is there. So you see all the images of the textures. So now to Blender, let me delete this. So I'll click on File, Import FBX. So I'm going to select the Genesis Female, Import. So this is what it looks like. I'm going to hide the bones. So now, right now, this is where the tutorial starts. This. So now, this character has so many materials. For instance, if I select the character and come here, you see that it has torso, face, lips, teeth, ears, leg, and so on and so forth. So if you want to edit this material right now, it's very metallic. And we all know humans are not metallic. So if I want to change the metallic property of this character skin, if I do this, you see that it's only updated for the torso alone. It's not working for the arms, and it's not working for the legs, the face, so on and so forth. So what this tutorial is about is that I want to use the UDIM material, that's UDIM, that's the U dimension. So you know we have UV, so this character has this UV, and each UV is splitted into the UV space. So this one is 0 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and so on and so forth. So right now, I want to use just one material. So, and if I use one material, I will be able to edit all the properties at once. So how do I do this? Let me just go to edit mode, select the mesh, and assign everything, the torso to everything. So right now, it's just the torso that is assigned to other parts of the body. So if I come here, so it's just the torso. So now I can just come here and click on, okay, let me go to UV. Click on image, view, repeat. So right now, the torso is showing for the face, the torso is showing for the leg, the torso is showing for the arms, and so on and so forth. And that is not what we want. We want the torso to show for torso, the legs to show for legs, the face to show for face. So how do we do this? The first thing we do is we select, we've already selected the mesh and assigned it torso. That's the first step. I'll change the single image to UDIM. So right now, it recognizes this, but it's not recognizing the other textures. So how do we fix this? Very simple. Just go to your images. We need to rename the images. So I'll go to the first one. So now, right now we have GBF base face map. So this won't work because they have different names. This one has G8F base face map D. This one has base legs, base torso, base arm. For UDIM to work in Blender, the images have to have the same name before the numbers. So now, what do we do? We can change this to G8F base. We remove the face and the others. So just copy, then rename the others. Paste, paste. So now I'll go back to my material, reselect it, and it's working. So now any changes I make is going to work for all the textures. So I can add a RGB curve. Just say, so we can reduce the not subsurface specular width to, let's say, 0.5, and so on and so forth. So with UDIM, you can actually edit your textures at once. So now I can just remove unused slots. So I have torso. I can change this to body or skin. So we have torso, teeth, and the likes. So now it's easy to edit the textures or manipulate the textures. You can also use this for any other character. It doesn't necessarily have to be just DAZ alone. As far as the UV has the UDIM layout, you can use the same thing. And the texture of the UDIM layout, you can use the same method for your other textures. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to our channel if you've not done so. Until next time, stay true to your creativity. Bye-bye.